Welcome to Meet and Match, digital platform of Linea Pelle Fair. For Smart Matching Edition, we are pleased to have here Carlos of Fortu. Hello, Carlos.
Hi, Oretta. How are you? I'm so pleased to be here. It's very nice to be here with Linea Pelle, sharing with all of the people who have seen us our thoughts today.
Thank you, Carlos. Really, thank you. Tell me more about your journey.
Oh, my journey is like quite easy as a journey as a designer. I'm an architect as a background. So what I'm trying to actually is to focus everything more into design, into architecture, and try to get the inspiration from that part of the world. So I think it's quite like not forgetting, but more going into design in order to create my fashion brand, which is not, I don't like to call fashion, I'd like just to call design or little architectures in leather.
Interesting. So you talk about design, you talk about bags. I think materials are very important for you.
Of course, materials are, for me, are the first thing that I look for, especially leather. We and my partner wanted to make a brand that represented especially not only this time but also the Italian way of working. I think the leather for us was the starting point to do that. And also the leather was like, as an architect, like it was the brick for our construction.
So what are you looking for in terms of materials?
In terms of materials, after this year that has been quite different for everybody, I'm looking for more into natural materials, things that looks real. I mean, I think after years and years, I think that the water is good because it's water. So leather is good because it's leather. So I just looking at the leather that is nice and looks like leather, with nice colors. I think also the techniques, already we have to think more into the future, sustainability and things like that. But I think it's something that is part of the work, of our work. So we don't have to talk every day about the techniques, because I hope that all the tanners are working in that. So I just would like to have more leathers that look like leathers, or their improvement is like leathers. And but are resistant and are a part of our daily life.
I understand that in your imagination, leather has to be real leather, and the technology could be maybe lightness, maybe some elements who are hidden, but they are part of the architectural construction.
Yes, it's exactly what I would like to have. Leathers that looks like leathers, colors that are nicer, I mean, they are not specifically colors from the leathers that we imagine, and the technology, as you said, is kind of hidden, because I don't think we have our daily lives is like we are already used to that. So without asking, we are looking for lighter materials, we are looking for more resistant materials. So I think that is something that is working between the designer and the tannery and also the final consumer. So it's something that is, we don't have any every day to talk about it, but intrinsically we are asking for that.
Correct. Let me ask you, what is missing from the proposal in this case of leather materials?
I think this proposal is quite wide. For me, as I told you, I'm looking just for different grains, but different natural grains, in order also to talk to the final consumer that the leather, the grain, is not only a treatment. It's the skin, but the skin is not because it's like more grain or less grain. It will be wilder or less wilder. It's like the leather is the nature of the leather. So that's, I just want to talk about textures, but natural textures that I think you have here a lot, But for me, it's important that to the possibility of touching, that is quite interesting when you have a bag, especially our bags that is, they are made of nothing.
Interesting. Why are you saying your bags are made for nothing?
Our bags are made of nothing, and it's like an object that you want to have, but it's like we try to put everything the less as we can. So we are not using so many hardware, we are not using so many distractions. We just wanted to have, like, when you ask to a child, please draw me a bag, and he makes like a rectangle and only just a circle, just to show you there are the handles. That is what we wanted to do also. So it's more the interesting part is the design, the simple design, the details that they have are in this design, and also the material, you know, the surface and the colors of the material. So there's no distractions. It's not like seasonal distraction, there's no fashion. We are looking for the season. We like the colors, so we like the proposals, just to keep moving on and forward. But it's, the object has been the object, and as an object that lasts forever. I think that is sustainability, you know, last forever.
So, how your consumer change it?
Our consumer is changing, but I think more than our consumer, we are changing as a designer. So our conscience is more into design, less into fashion, less into seasonally. We are more in, more, let's say, design and architecture are forward. So it's like looking for objects that are part of not only like fashion accessories, that's part of your daily life and your, let's say, your chart of things that you have at home. That is not only for going out, is that you can have also on a table, or you can have besides you, because this, now we are not working only in the office, we are working all around in the at the home, we are working in the streets, you are working in working sharing spaces. So that is our bags, is that is not a bag, it's an object that you take with you the whole journey.
Fortu is an object for your life, is the bag of your daily journey.
Yeah, I think it's the bag for the daily journey, and it's a bag that I hope that you get more, let's say, you will love more for the in the time, and also it gets more beauty with the years. I hope so.
Thank you, Carlos.
Thank you, Aretha. That's so nice to be here, and thank you for the invitation.
Thank you.